Naked video. Frank Skinner and David Baddiel now on BBC Two in a league of their own.
Before we start, look, we've got the Goodyear blimp.
Oh, so we have.
You know, you get these things over football matches, and they take that really good aerial shot that helps.
Let's have a look at that. There it is. See, it's very useful, isn't it?
I love the old Goodyear blimp. No?
Anyway, this week, Satan Greavesy finally conclude their overlong and frankly tedious investigation.
It's very harsh.
It is.
Some people like it.
Yeah.
Four people in Britain.
You are.
I will be saying a big hello to Ian Bogey.
Hello, I'm Ian Bogey.
Hello. Oh, I wouldn't pick him. I've said it.
Very good.
Thank you very much. But first, a few things we noticed from watching football this week. As Colombian star Faustino Espria arrived at St James's Park, unfortunately, one of the polythene bags in his luggage burst. And we discover the man who coached Peter Beardsley in his early years. I knew there'd be some reason for it.
And it's good to see that Barry Davis is doing his bit for the Care in the Community project.
Don't be shy. Here's Stato. That's it, there we are.
And Graham Kelly has beaten his own previous record for staring too long into the camera at the end of the FA Cup draw.
That completes the draw. The ties will be played on the 17th, 18th and 19th of February.
Keep going,
go on,
Graham.
Stop it, Graham. Look away. Graham. he's all bored
now. Oh, God, I thought his neck muscles had gone at the end there.
So...
Look at the blimp there, catching the light.
Isn't it lovely?
I'm often wondering, you know, what life is really like inside the Goodyear blimp.
Do you?
Oh, dear, you can't see anything from up here.
Oh, you haven't got it focused properly.
What match is it anyway, Julie?
It's Southampton versus Man City, Julie.
That's ridiculous. You can't tell which player's which. You don't know which way they're kicking. You haven't got a clue what's going on. It's like being Brian Moore.
No, hold on. It's getting clearer now. Now, Quinn's got the ball. Oh, he's going for goal. Yeah, you'll be careful what you're chucking out that window.
Yeah, Julie, remember what happened that time Brian Clough was up here?
To his right. Wright's trying to hand something here to the referee. It looks to me like a whiskey bottle.
Isn't it time for our break, Julie?
I think it is, Julie. My turn, I believe.
What's happening?
Here, is that us losing our signal?
No, Julie, it's Alan Ball losing his temper.
Anyway, let's get off.
What? We're getting already? There's still 5 minutes of the match left.
Well, I thought we'd leave early and miss the traffic.
Hold on, though. That's another blimp.
Oh, it's the Carlsberg blimp. We must be on the flight path from Villa Park.
Oh, no, don't panic. It's only Neil Roddick.
Better. You were a great Julie Goodyear, I thought.
Really?
Yeah, I really thought you were very good.
What's that? I thought you were a good Julie Goodyear.
Thank you very much. I thought, do you think Frank was a good Julie Goodyear?
No.
Yes.
No, don't just say it, you know. It's like saying, you know, I love you. If someone has to say it first before you say it back, it's not worthy. I love you, Statter.
He doesn't want to say it back, does he?
Well, now it's time for my news round. Only four games this week, with the results counting towards next week's scores. Not much change in the league table, so I thought I'd sing a song instead. What are you crazy? How in the hell can you just say what you just said?
I was talking to myself at the door and going to bed.
By the way, I forgot to say, your endearing mother called today.
Did you see Lisa?
Yes, I saw Lisa.
Is that why you're angry?
I wasn't angry. Not even maybe.
Must be the weather.
Now, don't be a baby. Well, how am I supposed to feel with all the things you don't reveal?
And you can't thank
your lucky stars that we're not as smart as you'd like to think we are.
Absolutely. You've outdone yourself this. Now I love you even more. Look, we had a letter from Dave Larkham from Newcastle upon Tyne, and he reckons that Picasso painted a picture of Peter Beardsley, which he saw. There he is. Look. There's Peter with the cup in his cup.
We also got something sent in by Mrs. J. Murden, which was also an artistic item, and this is a Roman bronze head, which was discovered. It's apparently from about 200 BC. It's a real thing. But if you look closer, you'll see the BC in this case, I think, stands for Bobby Charlton. Amazing, isn't it? It's a real bronze head. They've even got the bit of hair across the top of the head.
That is fantastic. And so we thought we'd have a look around the world of art, which we don't do very often.
No, we don't.
And see if we could find any other footballers. And apparently, around 1500 in Nigeria, I think the Nigerian nation of Benin, they had Jason Lee playing for them. There he is.
He hadn't developed the pineapple then so much, had he? It was more of a courgette.
Yeah, but he was getting there.
Then later on in the history of art, around about the time of the Impressionist period, this person, I can't remember the artist exactly, but I know that he drew this portrait of Julian Dix.
And here's one I particularly like. This was painted, I think, in the 1920s, and it's a lovely portrait of Ozzy Ardiles. And my own personal favourite, a bit of sculpture to end it. It's a lovely sculpture of Carlton Palmer. Just calling for the ball there, Curtis.
Yeah. Oh, and just one poem this week to round off the artistic note. This is from David Whitley from Loughborough, and it's an ode to Barry Fry, and it goes, Barry Fry, you smell. Barry Fry, you smell. Barry Fry, you smell. Very bad indeed. Fair enough, eh? I rather like it.
You know, Jeff Askell is a big mate of Barry Fry. Did you know
is he?
Him? Yeah, no, he'll be upset, Jeff will. Who is he?
I can't let him in. Professional what? Marvellous, it's Nick Owen and Susan Tully. Sorry about that. Goodness.
Some Americans in. Yeah. Hello, welcome. Both first time on the show and both doing very well. in Fancy League. Is it bottom but one and bottom but two?
That sort of thing, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, dear.
For anyone who doesn't know, that's a Luton top you have on, isn't it?
Yeah, much prized. Yeah, that's not.
And that's
not
a very.
These
they're
about.
Sponsored by a very appropriate company. What is it that they do?
Universal Salvage.
Salvage.
Auctions, yeah.
It's probably too late now, though, isn't it? One way or another.
And Sue, you're an Arsenal fan, of course.
Yeah, well, Dad used to take me as a kid to the reserves and stuff, so.
Just to the reserves?
No, so I started.
Do you have a drink, by the way, if you want a drink? There's lots of, you know,
yeah,
if you only come on the show because you get a lot
no.
of free drinks.
Thank you, Susan.
Don't want to
yeah. Cheers.
Because, you know, some people will do anything for a free drink.
When coolness is called for, make the right move. The move to the smooth one. Heineken.
Patrick Mower, again. Getting something free. Did you say hello to Ian Bogey on your way here?
I tell you what, I think he's got a real nose for a goal, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Fantastic play.
Look, that might work on daytime. But not in the grown-up world. Well, I tell you, you've always found the word bogey very funny, I understand, Susan, ever since you first started working in television.
What are you going to do?
Tell you what this is later on, OK? It's a surprise. And it's called slime. It's like a big bogey, but it's good.
Do anything. You said you wouldn't take the.
Very sweet indeed.
You were as cute as a button, so on that. I'd be proud.
I had a really bad lisp, actually. You were. That
was from a program called Our Show, which was. Because most people probably thought you started in Grange Hill, but
no,
there was a program before that called Our Show.
Yeah, so I was nine.
How old were you in that?
Nine.
And you weren't the only person on Our Show who went on to become famous, as you'll see.
Yes, we'll have Adrian Love from Capital Radio, and then we've got a Disney quiz coming up, but now it's over to Scotch Fitzgerald and If Only I Had the Words.
God, Nicholas Lindus. That's marvellous that you laughing at the word bogey like that, though, when you were 10. Because comedy was so much easier then, wasn't it? You just said the word bogey or pants or wee. You could get big laughs.
I still do, actually. Obviously.
Yeah, no, that is
well,
sort
we
of the
did
funniest
choose
thing.
Ian Bogey, not at random.
No, we didn't.
Because we thought it'd be quite funny.
Yeah.
Well, he's got a great nose for goal.
You know, I thought it went a bit better that time.
It's beginning to build,
isn't
it?
You said it with so much more confidence. Yeah. That's the way.
I forgot, that was probably the Sunday repeat. That's your time slot.
Yeah. It is, isn't it? The kids are watching and stuff. Yeah.
Your kids, actually, your kids are sporting. Kids, aren't they? They're playing cricket for Warwickshire, is that right?
That sort of thing, yeah. Sort of under 16, under 14, yeah.
Were you one of these parents who, when you had boys, thought, I could turn these into professional sportsmen?
Yeah.
Maybe I'd chain them up in the garden and bowled at them all day.
That's right, yeah.
Did you do all that?
Oh, God, yes. Spent half my life bowling at them, kicking at them and stuff like that. That's only in the house before we get out with a ball, you know.
Because Ivan Lendl's dad apparently used to tie him up in the garden.
I don't think we can say that. Lots and lots of kids now being picked up by football clubs at very, very young age. Are you aware of this?
Being poached.
Yeah, there's a kid called Sonny Pike who's he's on Ajax's books now. He's only about 11 or something.
There's one kid who's 22 months old who Leeds United. Did you see this kid? Aaron Lindley.
Yeah, he's picked up by Leeds.
22 months and went to Leeds.
He's a sort of violent problem child.
Well, apparently he can do back heels and everything. I'll soon train that out of him.
Oh. I wonder who that is.
I don't know. It's Sonny Pike! Hey.
Hello, Sonny. Didn't you used to be in Led Zeppelin? Nice to see you.
There's the boots, because you are a current player. We've got some baby boots there for you.
You're signed to Ajax, or are you having trials with Ajax?
I've had trials for Ajax, and they asked me to come back, so I was just going to play a couple of games a year.
So are you like the best kid at your school? Are you always picked first in the playground? Or do they think, no, we won't have that bloke who plays for Ajax, we'll have him?
I should warn you, you know when you got picked first, you know the little ugly kid at the end with the pot belly and the hooked nose who got picked last?
Yeah.
To get his own back on kids like you, they become referees.
True. So do you really, really want to be a professional footballer? Is that always what you wanted to be?
Yeah, I always wanted to be. Cause since I've been little, I used to watch, like, Liverpool.
Now, when did you start playing? When did you first kick a ball?
In the 1990 World Cup, around then.
I don't remember you at all. Shame in a way that you're going to Ajax. Why haven't Chelsea been in touch? Have you not had no English clubs?
He's too tall.
Have no English clubs been in touch at all?
Yes, been most of them. Like, you had Manchester United, Arsenal, Spurs, Norwich, Ipswich.
Well, so the whole of the Premier League.
And Luton.
not yet. Yeah, not Luton.
Say Luton. They're not on the phone yet, anyway. So,
so anyway, Nick. Goodness, who's this now?
That's a relief.
What's going on? Oh my God, it's your mum, Sonny.
I've told you before, don't play too close to that Stato bloke. Come on.
Sonny Pike, ladies and gentlemen. Nick, before you were known as you are as the king of daytime television.
Thank you, Dave.
Yeah, you were a sports journalist, weren't you?
Yeah, on radio and TV. I did sort of local radio, then ITV Sport.
It's interesting actually because Frank Boff was a sports journalist and went to daytime TV, and of course he was a transvestite.
Midlands telly a lot, I remember.
When you used to write to me, didn't you?
Yeah.
You looked up to me, didn't you?
Yeah. Yeah. I used to write and say, leave me alone. or I'm telling my parents.
When you were young, were you a sort of World of Sport man or a Grandstand man?
I used to like World of Sport. I used to like the aeroplane in the opening credits with the da-da-da-da-da-da. And Dickie Davis was fantastic.
Great bloke, yeah.
He never did finish painting that ceiling.
So pleased you've done it. Well, one thing about World of Sport, which you might not know, is that if you worked there long enough, eventually you got given a World of Sport blue tank top. And this gave you lots of privileges, and it gave you the privilege to actually piss any way you like.
It's quite unusual, actually. It's like being on the sporting side. And, yes. Tell me, are you going this afternoon?
I had one of those.
Did you?
Did you have one of them?
I had all these ITV Sport logo jobs, yeah.
Oh, look at you.
Seems a long time ago now.
Sorry, you carry on.
Okay.
Anne and I do that a lot as well.
Yeah.
Do what?
I'll tell you what I like, though. I'll tell you what I like what Anne does. If you talk to camera now, this is Anne and Nick, and
okay.
I'll be Anne.
Hello. Right. Later
so
on.
This is Nick, right, and I'm Anne. Right.
Later on, Kate O'Mara will be popping in to talk about still being sexy at 50. And then we'll be having a knitting section. And then, of course. And then we'll have, and then of course, some cooking with Aidsley the chef.
Oh, my God. For you.
Is it? Oh, no, I'm sorry. No, it's all over. No, I've said, I'm sorry, don't phone me at work. I can't see you anymore. I'm sorry. Duke of Edinburgh.
Well, you kept that bloody quiet.
Have you seen that Walker's Crisp? What happened there?
Nothing.
You're doing Anne Diamond.
Sorry, Anne.
Susan, have you seen that Walker's Crisps advert? The one for Salt and Lineker?
With Gazza Crime.
Yeah, what do you think of it?
Well, it was quite funny, actually. Sorry.
No, that's all right. What do you think, Nick?
I think it's brilliant.
I think it's terrible.
Right? It's based, we should point out, first of all, it's based on these. Their new Salt and Lineker crisps. It's a very clever
pun. Very clever little pun, yeah. And there's more in the range, actually. You'll find Smokey Beckham.
Well, Smokey Beckham, thanks very much.
No, but what worries me about it? What's up with it?
Poached when there were new potatoes.
I'll tell you why I don't like it. I think it was a fantastic moment when Gazza cried. I was very, very moved indeed. And now they've just made, like, a silly rubbish joke out of it, which upsets me, because, of course, we would never desecrate a great football moment like that on this programme.
Well, it was his moment, wasn't it?
That's true. It was his moment.
And, no, I don't think it was his moment, you see. I think it was everybody's moment. I don't think he owns it anymore.
That's a beautiful thing to say.
No, I think it's I think it's true.
It's true.
I was
true.
Very upset. I remember when Gasser cried in the World Cup, which was odd, because a few days later, another fat bloke cried at the end of a World Cup game, and I thought it was really, really funny.
Nick, let's have a look at your team.
Dean and Campbell up front.
Yeah.
God, it's a sort of a donkey sanctuary. Yeah. you've got Carlton Palmer.
I like Carlton Palmer. He scored for me this week.
We had a letter. Someone, this is from David Haworth of Blackpool. Anyway, this is a genuine, this is a Guinness Book of Records. We've all had many happy hour with these, haven't we? And it's got on here, page 221, the hopscotch record for the longest recorded hopscotch marathon. And this was a kid who hopscotched for 70 hours. And his name was Carlton Palmer. And it's him.
Let's have a look at him.
There's Carlton hopping, look.
And at the same time, he was breaking the record for the longest legs in the world.
But even then, the scouts were after him, weren't they? Which is fantastic. Very good.
I should say, but on a serious note, we get a lot of letters to the show saying that there isn't enough. Liked.
Really? What? I thought that was just the World of Sports studio, but it's anywhere.
Any studio. Anywhere. Or flat.
Oh, well, Stato does it enough anyway.
Anyway, as I was saying, I was trying to get serious then as well. We get a lot of letters saying that there isn't enough clips for women on the show. Well, we hope that this will redress the balance.
If you lovely ladies can summon up the energy, have a baby shower.
Patrick Mauer on a free boat now. Unbelievable. Susan, let's have a look at your team.
Well, I mean, I started off quite well. Milosevic got me a hat-trick in the first round. And Jason Lee's earned more points than Bergkamp, I think. And scored more goals than Mark Hughes.
Yeah.
And Cantona. So.
It is about time someone came on the show and defended Jason Lee.
yeah, a bit unfair there.
Somebody sent us a letter that was a list of strikers in the Premier League who's got less goals than Jason Lee this season. And there's a lot of them.
It was actually on this piece of paper. Yeah. What about Brian McClair? Has he done well for you? How many points has Brian McClair got?
How many points?
McClair, weeks. Not really played at all, so he's not really figured.
Yeah, he's on reserve.
Yeah, playing is usually the best thing to do, I think. Because actually, it's caused him a lot of psychological problems not playing for United. He's just turned into one of those mad blokes you see on the street. Funny hat.
Frightened me to death.
Do you want Fancy some York scratching.
Oh, York scratching! But, some Carl Reddy salted. I just did it for the QPR fan the other night. Three QPR fans, actually. That's more or less an end.
Do you...
Anyway, now it's time for the last ever episode of Saint and Greavesy Investigate.
Saint and Greavesy? Private investigators are hot on the trail of Terry Venables and his reasons for not picking Matthew Letizia. After Venables gives them the brush off, they find he's left behind the key to his inner sanctum.
He didn't drop any other keys, did he?
Jimmy,
Dear Mr. Venables, perhaps you could explain why the excellent Phoenix from the Flames has been replaced by a pile of...
Hey, Jimmy! Look at this! Yeah, this one's the tape from the surveillance camera. Perhaps this'll tell us who's been giving Terry advice on how to pick a team.
Look at that.
Here, Saint, listen to this. December the 12th, 1994. Saw Matthew Letissier. He's brilliant. What a player. January the 5th, 1995. I will not rest until I have made Letissier the centrepiece of my England team.
I don't understand,
Jimmy. Oh, hang on, Saint. February the 18th. After what I saw today, I will never pick Matthew Letissier again.
Did you say February the 18th?
Yeah.
That's the date on this tape. Oh. This must be what he saw on that day.
So in conclusion, and bearing in mind everything I've said,
I think you must agree that Matthew Letissier really is the greatest. He's not just the greatest thing since sliced bread. He's the greatest thing since bread of all kinds.
There you go, Matthew. The reason Terry Venables won't pick you for England can be summed up in two small words. Ted and, of course, Rogers.
It ain't fair, Ted bloody Rogers.
Let's see what's on the news.
And now sport. In a shock decision, Terry Venables has resigned from the post of England manager. In a statement released today, Mr. Venables said that unless the person who broke into his drinks cabinet replaces the three stolen bottles of whiskey, he will not return. Mr. Venables has also complained that his office has started to smell like a urinal. The FA announced that his replacement will be former England manager Bobby Robson.
Oh, brilliant. He loves me, Robson. I'll be in for sure.
Well, what were you waiting for? Let's go out and celebrate.
The FA have recommended that Mr. Robson work closely with their official advisor.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bobby
Susan and to Nick, thank you very, very much indeed.
And best of luck with the rest of the season. And don't give up hope. Next week's guests are Sarah Cook and Graham Souness.
Oh, doorbell.
That reminds me, I must have bought me holidays. All right, Jeff.
How is Frank?
That's the young Nick Lindhurst.
I sure have, mate, yep.
Jeff, ask the last.
Poor old Johnny Ray. Sounded sad upon the radio. Moved a million off in your. How mothers you. Say more than ever. Come on, Eileen. Oh, I swear we'll leave that this moment you mean everything. With you in that dress, my thoughts I confess, they're done dirty. Oh, come on, Eileen.
If you want to write to us, our address is Fantasy Football League, P.O. Box 168. London WC2H 7BU.
Oh, come on, Eileen!
More comedy in 5 minutes here on BBC Two with the team from Naked Video.